Wisdom in the number of man. For centuries, the concept of the Antichrist has fascinated and intrigued Bible prophecy fans. The idea of a powerful figure rising to prominence, deceiving the masses, and leading them astray has captured the imagination of both believers and skeptics. The word Antichrist is only specifically mentioned in John's epistles, but other passages in the Bible are associated with Antichrist. The beast or false prophet of Revelation 13, Daniel's little horn, and Paul's son of perdition, the man of lawlessness, are examples. In Revelation 13:18, John says, "Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. What is wisdom? Is it historical knowledge about Rome and its rulers? Is it modern knowledge about society and politics? The Bible says, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the holy is understanding." Proverbs 9:10. Respect God with love and faith. Love His laws and follow the one He sent, Jesus. Philosophy is the love of wisdom. Wisdom is more about morality and ethics than it is about history. So who has the understanding to calculate the number of the beast? We have examples from the early church. The Epistle of Barnabas and Clement of Alexandria used a philosophical method based on the Bible to determine that 318 was a symbol of Jesus and the cross. In the Epistle of Barnabas, a 2nd century text, 318 servants of Abraham are said to foreshadow Christ. 318 appears in the Stromona by Clement of Alexandria. It states, "For, hearing that Lot was taken captive, and having numbered his own servants, born in his house, 318 he defeats a very great number of the enemy." The numerological representation of Jesus with the number 888, as the sum of the numerical values of the letters of his name, was condemned by the Church Father Irenaeus as convoluted and an act which reduced the Lord of all things to something alphabetical. Irenaeus, a disciple of Polycarp who was a disciple of John, was also aware that some versions of the Apocalypse have the number 616 instead of 666. He attributed 616 to a scribal error. He then authenticated as follows. "For Noah was 600 years old when the deluge came upon the earth, sweeping away the rebellious world, for the sake of that most infamous generation which lived in the times of Noah." And Antichrist also sums up every error of devised idol since the flood, together with the slaying of the prophets and the cutting off of the just. And such, then, being the state of the case, and this number being found in all the most approved and ancient copies of the Apocalypse, and those men who saw John face to face bearing their testimony to it, while reason also leads us to conclude that the number of the name of the beast, if reckoned according to the Greek mode of calculation by the value of the letters contained in it, will amount to 666, that is, the number of tens shall be equal to that of the hundreds, and the number of hundreds equal to that of the units, for that number which expresses the digit 6 being adhered to throughout, indicates the recapitulations of that apostasy, taken in its full extent, which occurred at the beginning, during the intermediate periods, and which shall take place at the end. Surprisingly, Irenaeus wasn't the first one to come up with this method of calculation. The Jewish philosopher Philo of Alexandria noted Noah's age at the time of the flood, and came up with the following calculation. "And the 600th year has for its origin the number 6, and the world was created under the number 6, therefore, by the same number does he reprove the wicked, putting them to shame because he would, unquestionably, never, after he had created the universe by means of the number 6, have destroyed all the men who lived on the earth under the form of 6, if it had not been for the preposterous excess of their iniquities. For the third power of 6 and the minor power is the number 600, and the mean between both is 60, since the number 10 more evidently represents the likeness of unity, and the number 100 represents the minor power." Philo doesn't mean power in the modern sense. He is talking about the digit's place. The thing about Philo is he wrote before John wrote the Apocalypse. So this understanding of 666 preceded the book of Revelation. It is apostasy in the beginning, the present, and the end that is represented by 666. Jesus spoke of these rebellions against God's law and created order in Luke 17. He spoke about the day of the Son of Man, the days of Noah, and the days of Lot. Who else spoke about the number of a man? Here is another surprise. It was the Greek philosopher Plato. Now this number represents a geometrical figure which has control over the good and evil of births. For when your guardians are ignorant of the law of births, and unite bride and bridegroom out of season, the children will not be goodly or fortunate. Plato speaks of human births out of season and out of order with the law of births and the nuptial law. These are unions that are out of order with nature and produce evil children. He even mentions that six represents the circle of time. The point is that the man of lawlessness represents apostasy and a rejection of God's created order and natural law. Philosophically, it is apostasy in the beginning, now, and in the end. Remember Luke 17. So what is the name of the man of apostasy, lawlessness, and sin? Compare 2 Thessalonians 2 through 4 to 2 Corinthians 2, 6, 15 and 16. The name Belial or Belier means worthless or lawless. And what concord hath Christ with Belial? Or what part hath he that believeth with an infidel? And what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? For ye are the temple of the living God, as God hath said, I will dwell in them, and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people.